Hey, what's up, everybody? This is your boy Lowell Pye, and you're watching Gospel Hits 1.
Hey fam, welcome back to another blessed edition of Gospel Hits 1. As you see, we're here at Friendship Baptist Church in Mobile, Alabama, which means we have some awesome interviews coming your way. Plus, you know we're going to bring the top videos. So stay tuned, sit back and relax, because you're about to have a good time. Plus, we have God's Child with the video with We Own on the best show on the planet. That's Gospel Hits 1.
Being that God's Child has been doing music since 2001. What keeps you guys motivated as a group to stay together?
It's like we're born for another person's benefit. And you can't never stop what you're doing, because if you stop, then they'll never start. So if you got that in mind, you'll know that this process is ongoing and you're holding somebody up. Perpetual is my mindset, so you can't say it ain't my time yet. Man, I was just praying that I could be, but I just left A, rapidly approaching C. See, I'm a teacher with his composition, more than a conqueror compared to my competition. Translation, I'm back in transition. God, I'm unable to apprehend me like the hands missing. Sure, I be spitting that left field. Immortality replaced the void death field. Now while we living in this death field, amongst me and turn mannequins, the ones that's left real, still overcoming this oasis. I reside on the throne on a permanent basis. I keep it so luxurious, fully furnished and spacious, to stay 50 paces ahead of your faces, man.
And we don't write hooks, we write cross. Limelight extra bright, turn the lights off.
Enticing to live my life foul. She may not be a dog, but she a barker, just like Kyle. She living single, she hot as a jalapeno. Giorgio Armani, flashy like a casino. One day, we'll be together, that's what she hopes. I tell her, slow down, she listens to Valentino. She said, since you a Christian, you can save me. I thought about that ring on my finger my wife gave me. I thought about the time I acquired my first baby. Wow, I guess being on is just phase three. She tries to be everything to me, my wife's not. So I'm on, won't let her zone on my wife's spot. I gotta take the right shot, hardball like a white sock. I give her the cold shoulder, I expose her to my ice.
And we don't write hooks, we write cross. Limelight extra bright, turn the lights off. And we on, and we on, and we on. Never off, baptized in the Milky Way. Shining stars, gotta lead the way. Yeah, and we on, and we on, and we on. Never off, and we don't write hooks, we write cross. Limelight extra bright, turn the lights off. And we on.
Gospel Hits 1. As you see, I'm here with none other than Lowell Pye. How you doing today, sir?
Oh, I'm doing pretty good. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. Well, I want to thank you for being on the show.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Hey, we love to have great artists and do great interviews. But a lot of people know you from Men's Standard, but a lot of people don't know that you was one of the lead singers in John P. Key on the song Jesus Is Real.
Yeah.
Can you tell us the progression from going to a choir to a group to now a singer?
Well, I mean, you know, it was a blessing to be able to travel with John P. Key for the amount of years that we did 4 years with him, and so got a chance to travel everywhere, go everywhere. Went to places like Iowa, you know, I don't think any gospel artists go to Iowa and South Dakota and stuff like that, so we had a chance to do that. And then he taught us a lot about the business, and so that was our learning ground right there to go out and venture out. And so 1994, you know, we decided to leave, myself and Isaac, we started to leave and start a group. And so it took us a while, because I think sometimes people break away too fast, and the timing is everything when you do that, you know what I'm saying? So I think when you break away, you have to make sure that it's your season and your time. So it wasn't our time to start ministering yet. So I started working at UPS and then got a job, a second job at Sam's Club. And so Isaac started working with me at UPS. And so he said, look, about maybe a week or two in, he said, hey man, I ain't doing this no more. It's too much. He quit and I kept on working. And so finally we got a chance to start the group in the end of 1995 and started on our record 1996. And you know, the rest is history. And here we are again today. 13 years we've been standing. We're still together. You know, we're gonna come back later on and do a live record called The Live Experience in Atlanta, Georgia. But God, again, took me out of the group for a moment to say, there are some things that I need you to share with the people of God everywhere, but you can't do it with the group. You're gonna have to do it by yourself. And I believe that there's people who's has my name on their life, that Isaac can't do it, Minister can't do it together. It's Lowell's assignment, and so we're doing it now, and I'm doing it, you know, my thing now, and God's been, man, he's been faithful to me, and I'm just excited about what he's doing.
Before I go to sleep at night, I pray for you.
somebody who cares. When I found you, found my most intimate prayer. When I found you, I found what every heart dreams of. When I found you, I found love. When I found you, I found the rest of my life. When I found you, I told all others goodbye. When I found you, I saw my fears fly away like a dove. When I found you, I found love.
Sometimes taking care of God's business is uncomfortable. Sometimes it's like, I'm comfortable here. I'm comfortable with my fellows because I know they got my back. I don't know about going by myself because it's all me now. And I can't look back and by myself. But God said, listen, when you do it, don't worry. I'm going to have you something to say. You're going to have some substance to tell the people about what you've been through and how you battled with so many different things. Man, and God has been blessing. God's really been blessing.
Well, that's awesome. So now you're here. Can you tell us about your current project?
Well, the current project is called Finally. I was on the phone one day with Isaac. We was just talking about our journey through the gospel industry. And I said, man, can you believe that finally we get ready to do a solo record? He was like, no, that's the title of your record. Finally. So we named it Finally. It's a great project. 1 to 13. It's easy music. It's nothing. You know, everybody that know me know I'm a church guy. You know, I'm going to do what I do. You know, I'm not going to try to venture out and do nothing. No, I'm going to do what I'm comfortable and what God has called me to do. So it's a church record with some praise and worship, quartet music on there. I have some guest appearances. Bishop Marvin L. Winans, my mentor. Bishop Rance Allen. Sherry Jones Moffitt. And Deidre Catton. And wow. So just some friends of mine came together, just really helped me out. I love the project. You know, I'm currently even working on another project because that project did pretty good for me as far as just getting me, you know, people to get, you know, used to me being by myself. So the next project is going to be great. I can't wait to tell you about the next project.
That's okay. Amazing. So when you planning for the next project?
Well, the next project is going to be 2012, the summer 2012. It's called Transform. I went through a transition in my life, man, where God was dealing with me, and I went through an intervention. And I had to sit there with some people who was telling me about me. And I tell people all the time that one of the most uncomfortable positions and places in life is when people have to tell you the truth about you. Because we live in denial, and we don't want to hear the truth. We want to hear the good stuff about us. Yeah. But we don't want nobody to tell the bad stuff. And people was telling the bad stuff about me. And that happened September 11th, September the 12th. I woke up, I said, God, show me me. I want to see what those people was talking about, because I couldn't even hear him because I was feeling so bad and crying. And he said, I'm gonna do it, but when I do it, it ain't gonna be pretty. It's gonna be ugly. What they said is really there. And he began to do it. A Bible was sitting next to me, and I opened the Word of God. Went to Romans 12. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your body a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is a reasonable service. Got to this part where it said, but be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. God was saying, son, there's nothing that you will be able to do in life. You won't be able to accomplish nothing. Be a great father. You will never be a great husband when you get married. Nobody will be able to do anything until they first renew their mind. First thing you have to do, you have to renew your mind in him, loving him, and then renew your mind in the way you think about things. And God has just been blessing me. And to that date, 116 days today, I lost like 40-something pounds. Wow. Because of my mind.
Yeah.
You know, we always start something. I'm going to start it on Monday. I'm starting New Year's. I'm gonna start it. And it never we started, and we might do good one day. The next day, we fall off because it's not made up in our minds.
Yeah.
And so that's the name of the record, Transform.
Wow, that's awesome. Awesome word. I know the people will be blessed by that testimony. Yes.
This is a large, violent tornado. Look at that. Goodness gracious. This will be a day that will go down in state history. And all you can do is pray for those people.
I know you're hurting. And yes, I know you may be sad. God has, he has you in his hand. Yes, he does. He wants to know, will you trust him when it seems too much to bear? Yes, God sees and he knows. Yes, he can.
I know
we can.
When you go.
It's simple.
Learn the business. You know, know that it's ministry first, but it's still a business. And you have to know what you're signing, what you're trying to get into. And then the number one thing is make sure that you've been called to do it. Because it's not, gospel is not like secular. You can have one hit and be millionaires. Mm-hmm. Gospel, you might not make it, you know, millions. But your reward is in heaven.
Amen.
So you have to make sure that you've been called to do it. And when you've been called to do it, and you know that God has called you to do it, and regardless if anybody pay you or not, you're willing to get the good news out to the men, you know, and to people that aren't saved, and that are in church. And God will take its stamp, and stamp his approval on your gift and your ministry, and it will become a success. And then you'll start seeing the fruits of your labor because of your faithfulness. He said, love the Lord, love me. Keep your eyes on me, keep focused on me. He said, because I'll preserve the faithful. I'll protect the faithful. And then it said in another translation, this is Psalms 30-something, 24, somewhere around in there. He said, love the Lord. He said, I preserve the faithful. And he said, and your haters, I'm going to deal with.
Yeah.
You ain't got to talk about your haters. Yeah. You ain't got to worry about. If you just keep your eyes on God and keep it faithful to God and be faithful to God and be diligent in the walk and in the faith, God said, I'll preserve it. I'll protect you from everything. Mm-hmm. And I'll take your ministry and stamp my approval on it. And you may, man, you won't have room to receive the blessing that I will have restored upon it. So that's the only thing I have to say. Be faithful to God. Be diligent. Learn the business. Get you a good attorney that know what they're talking about. That's going to teach you why they're dealing with this other stuff and dealing with the business. So you'll know what you're doing. Mm-hmm. And then everything will be all right.
Well, there you have it. Another awesome show. So I hope you were blessed. If you would like to be a part of Gospel Hits 1, send us an email at gospelhits1@yahoo.com. This has been Gospel Hits 1. I'm Corey P. P. Miller is behind the scene today. Bless ones out. Peace.